The legends tell of a man. A man who once made something that everyone all agreed was a point in history where everything changed. It was loved. It was hated. But most of all, it was important. It changed the way we looked upon its brethren for years to come. The man who created this monument of history at that moment became a prophet, and in the years to come, a prophecy came with it. A prophecy that predicted that one day, our prophet would return. He would bring with him the ultimate in what his vision lied upon. However, it is said that the prophecy was mistold, and those who predicted it believed it had already happened. The prophet made a creation so powerful, so accidental in its beauty, that any attempts to improve upon it were only met with scorn. Many people were caught up in this melee, and many lives were claimed. And that they were claimed by it because they believed nothing else would be better despite everything they love about it being complete exploits and programming mistakes. In the years to come, the Prophet would create two more times. And each time he created, he was met with what many believe to be the epitome of ambivalence. Those who loved the creation met it with love and admiration, while those claimed by the melee would speak only with venom and malice in their hearts. However, the prophecy has been fully translated, and it has turned out that we were wrong all along. The prophecy told of an ultimate, and now we finally see it on the horizon. The prophecy has been fulfilled. Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has finally been shown. Its majesty, glowing like a warm, loving angel, ready to absolve us of our sins. It even shows forgiveness for those caught in the melee. It shows kindness even to them, giving them what they desire. Not with spite, but with love. With compassion. It is not here just to please us. It is here to forgive us. It is here to be with us, with love, and offering its hand in friendship.
And yet people are still complaining about it! Ha ha! Greetings, everyone! I am Hipster the Wolf, and with that long-winded and overly blown introduction out of the way, welcome to another episode of Snooty and the Beast. So, Best Smash Direct, am I right? I'm not going to dwell on this any more than I should, but I am going to put this right here for my own enjoyment.
Oh my god, Simon and Victor Belmont, this is the best thing ever! Holy monkey on a stick thing and bananas! I love you, Soccer! Are you madman genius, you?
With that said, everyone is all asking the same question now that the Direct is over with. What is up with how much frickin' music is in this game? Seriously, you can even play this game like an MP3 player? This is gonna be the best thing ever! Focus, Hipso, focus! No, the blurred out images on the menu, here and here. What are these things? More importantly, why are both of these blurred out? Why didn't Sakurai have anything to say about it right now? Speculation time, everyone, because I have a few theories. First of all, let's all take a look back at what Smash has done with their menus in the past. Smash 64. Pretty basic, self-explanatory, let's move on. Smash Melee. This one was a little more interesting. At first it seems as simple as the 64 one, but when you highlight an option, you also see a preview of what you'll get when you enter that menu. This is what kept everything slick and to the point. Nothing was confusing. Smash Brawl. This was very similar to Melee's menu, except a lot flashier. The major difference being that when you entered solo play, instead of there being a regular play option, all the main modes were front and center. And Adventure Mode, Subspace Emissary, stuck out way more than the others. This was designed to draw your attention to it, like, this is the main attraction of the game, the feature presentation! And it certainly was! It was the most ambitious thing we had ever seen with Smash Bros. At this point. Heck, some would argue it's still the most ambitious thing in Smash to this day! And this leads us to Smash 4. Okay, seriously, what is this? Why are all the menu buttons spread out so haphazardly? Why are the options on the games and more? Why is the worst mode in the game front and center on this main frickin' menu? I hate this menu. I really hate this menu. But at the same time, it betrays what Sakurai has in store for us. For you see, the mysterious blurred out game mode will be... Smash Tour 2! Now with even bigger maps to make you question even more about what the point of this is! No. Good God, I hope Sakurai's not that daft to make that mistake again. Especially since Ultimate seems to be tailor-made as the make everyone happy Smash game everyone wants. Now, I believe what everyone believes. This is the return of Adventure Mode. However, I predict that this is not going to be the Adventure Mode everyone is familiar with. Let me explain. One of the more controversial elements of Subspace Emissary is a little level that you play at the very end of the story, the Great Maze. Already I know some of you are cringing at the mere mentioning of this, but level with me, I'm going somewhere with this. The Great Maze failed for one fundamental reason. It was essentially a boss rush level, except the game was telling you to find those bosses in this massive maze that you had little to no idea how to navigate, and once you finally did know how to navigate it, it just made it all the more aggravating to know that you still had to fight every single boss in the game, as well as every fighter as a dark clone! It wasn't a good level. However, funny enough, I used to love playing this level when I first got to it. Until this point, we were playing linear levels and they were all pretty, well, boring. But the Great Maze was kind of a sandbox Smash adventure. You were able to explore it at your own pace, there was no time limit. You were able to switch out your characters at any time at save points. It felt like a Metroidvania Smash Brothers.
Ooh, you suck!
Fast forward to Smash 4, or to be more specifically, Smash for the 3DS. With it came essentially the Smash Brothers version of City Trial from Kirby Air Ride, though admittedly not as fun. Smash Run put you in a massive maze where you got to fight enemies from all across Nintendo history, with various events going on, and you get to power up your character under a strict time limit until you square off in a final showdown when the timer goes off. They essentially took the Great Maze, condensed it into a smaller, more easily digestible area to explore, and told you to go completely nuts until the timer goes off. This, I believe, was the glimpse we need into the future, a glimmer of hope for what to expect from this blurred out option. I believe that Smash Run will be expanded upon, the time limit removed, and repurposed as a single-player Metroidvania world to explore, with areas being blocked off that you need to unlock to progress, only instead of power-ups like traditional Metroidvanias, you unlock fighters. Sakurai said during the E3 Direct that he wanted to streamline the process of unlocking fighters, starting with a Smash 64 roster and working your way up to unlock new fighters. I believe that they're going to do it like this. And most clever of all, Adventure Mode will be a roguelike. The world will be procedurally assembled together. When you die, that's it. Game over. However, just like in Subspace Emissary, when you unlock fighters, you have them as lives as well. And best part of all is that if you manage to win, you keep all the fighters you were able to keep alive, as well as any loot you might have found as well. Like maybe gold for the vending machine for trophies or stickers, or new music tracks or something. And that brings us to the blurred out option on the sidebar. I think this will work in conjunction with Adventure Mode, a streamlined version of the challenges from Smash 4. Except this time, it will be used as a progress marker of how much of the world in Adventure Mode you've unlocked and what you might see on your next run through. Now, obviously, I have absolutely no proof on all this. In all honesty, this is less of a speculation and more of a thing that I really hope they do. But with that said, I personally believe that what I designed here would be a perfect fit for Smash Ultimate. It's, pardon the pun, the ultimate way to streamline the content unlock system. By having everything you could ever want all condensed in a randomly generated world that you can replay again and again and again, suddenly you're in a position to be able to add a multitude of different things to this mode to make it even wackier. Maybe gravity's a little off. Maybe suddenly you're using stamina instead of percentages. Maybe... Maybe you're suddenly able to temporarily play as assist trophies! Make it happen, Sakurai! Oh my god, this is gonna be the best game ever! I'm so hyped!
He's hips to the wall, but he's just gonna freak out about Smash Ultimate for a little while. I hope you all enjoyed this video. For once, I think I might actually hope that Hipso's right, because that would be awesome. Also, leave some comments down below of what you think of this. Is this a good idea? Maybe there's a different idea you had in mind? Let's get this discussion going. Check you guys later, and we hope to see you again next time.
I'll break to this train! Full stop to December, baby! I am so ready for this! I'm gonna pass out now. Holy cow, that was exhausting.